One of my favorite articles that came out recently was Dynamic Assessment article, Word Learning in African-American Toddlers of Middle to Low Socioeconomic Status. This came out in 2007, Horton-Ikard and Weismer. Weismer's done a lot of work on dynamic assessment and non-word repetition tasks as well. So how do we normally assess semantic knowledge? Semantics being vocabulary. Vocabulary is just the labeling. Semantics is an understanding, those semantic webs of all things. How much do you know about that word? So, norm reference, standardized vocabulary test, your PPVT, your EPVT, your subtests on your expressive vocabulary test, your expressive one-word picture vocabulary test, your subtests in your psych, your ed, your speech. That's how we do it. Lexical diversity measures. Most speech people do this or have been exposed to this. Type token ratios and number of different words. And the third thing, which is what these researchers looked at, was word learning tasks such as fast mapping. Now we know from the research that vocabulary tests with show socioeconomic differences. So do you want to test a child's socioeconomic background or do you want to test their ability to learn words? With the vocabulary test, standardized vocabulary test, you're testing socioeconomic status. You can't separate out socioeconomic status from their ability to learn words, so you don't want to use them. Type token ratio and number of different words, they're both derived from speech samples, between 50 and 100 utterances, as we know from the Hart and Risley study that we looked at yesterday in day one, and the Penny and Quinn study that we looked at in day one. Labeling vocabulary words and labeling are differentiate children's exposure to vocabulary words differentiates based on socioeconomic status. So again, number of different words and type token ratios, we're looking at socioeconomic status. We can't pull that socioeconomic status apart from a disorder. So word learning tasks is quick incidental learning. What we want to see here is whether the children can learn words that we give meaning to and learn it fast. The non-word repetition tasks, non-word repetition tasks, they're not words, right? And we're not, when we say voital babe and repeat that, we're not giving that any meaning. Here, something else we would do in dynamic assessment, which is fast mapping word learning tasks. Here we go. So what we want to do is see if the children can increase their vocabulary right in front of you. Again, dynamic assessment. What you need for this great article to get, is a puppet. I sometimes, when I forget the puppet, I use my hand. A picnic basket or a basket that I put a little cloth over so you have something to open up. It's always fun when there's something to open up and find. And then you want four items. I use real items, not plastic. One is a cookie. One is an apple. I get them about small apples, you know, larger than a teeny cookie, just so they're all about the same size. Then I got two things the child would not know the label for, and then two what are called the dummy items. So yeah, you're going to be using six items altogether. I gave examples in this of rhubarb and parsley, but what I think I use in the videos, I know I use a lychee nut, tomatillo, a piece of garlic, and maybe a zucchini. So I'm hoping the kids don't know that, don't know what they are. And I usually have one or two extra in case I have a child who's from a father or a mother who's a chef. What they found was there were no significant differences in socioeconomic status, but from the ability of African-American toddlers, 30 to 40 months, that's a good age for us, to learn novel word meanings on a fast mapping task. Meaning, the children from the lower socioeconomic background who were typically developing performed at the same level as the kids who were from a higher socioeconomic background. So you took out the socioeconomic bias, which you have in standardized vocabulary tests, you have in the type token ratio, number of different words. So now we're going to look at a video of a little boy who is doing this exact task. This is a typically developing child.
Friend, I want to show you. Okay? This is my puppet. Do you want to meet him?
Hi, Dylan. I'm Mr. Puppet. We're going to go on a picnic today. Do you want to come?
Yeah.
Okay. you open the picnic basket? We have to put some things in. Oh, wait. Take it out. Okay, here we go. This? Oh, wait. Take it out. This is an apple. Can you put it in? Good job. This is a cookie. Can you put it in? This is a toe day. Can you put it in? This is a cube. Can you put it in? Will you put these things in too? Thank you. You're a good helper. I don't think I want to go on a picnic. Hey, can you take out the apple? Thank you. Hey, can you take out the cube? Good job. Thank you. Can you take out the cookie? Good job. Hey, can you take out the toe day? Cool, thanks. But I am kind of hungry. Maybe I'll eat. What's that?
An apple.
A what? What's this one?
An apple.
Oh. Wait! I'll have that! What's that? Oh, I want it. Oh, thank you. What's that one? What is that? Oh, a toe day. Thank you. On the picnic.
Yeah.
What should we take?
I want these.
All of those? Okay. What's this?
An apple.
Oh, okay. What's this?
A cube.
What's this one? A what?
A tortilla.
Oh, okay. What's this one?
A cookie.
Oh, all right. Thanks, Dylan. Okay, let's put the lid on. Let's go on our picnic.
As you can see, the comprehension came very, very quickly. And it stayed. The expression for one of them was good, but the other one he never quite got in terms of expression. This is a typically developing four-year-old. I thank Nikki Bina, who's the SLP who did this with me. I was doing the videotaping. And what I do love about him, what you see from this, is he actually knows what's going on. He knows there's novel words. So when she says, and what's this? And again, he has the comprehension, but not the expression. He says some jibba-jibba-da. He makes up a word for it, showing that he understands, he learned the rules of this game, and he applied them in a way that got him out of all kinds of trouble. Not trouble, but here's a typically developing kid. Right? Remember, I showed you the strategies of children already. We saw Andrea's strategy. I got only friends birds, and I don't want to tell you the rest. The little boy that we saw before with the mild to moderate delay, who repeated the words before I finished, and repeated the non-words before I finished, so he wouldn't have to remember them that long. And then the little girl, who actually just got quiet, more and more quiet, and didn't interact much because she knew she had a strategy. She knew this wasn't going to work for her from the beginning. She knew this was a hard task.